And now, the next part of Another World.
You see?
Are you all right?
Miss Grabberhopper scalded me.
How did you get in here?
Well, jusqu'aux os.
You look like a drowned rat.
How dare you disturb my patient when she's in ceremony?
Monsieur le médecin, vous savez bien que je suis Caswin, le fiancé.
I told you this patient was off limits.
Oh, you knew he was in there.
Yeah, it's my fault. I have a thing for Spider-Man.
Hey, Jenny.
You're reporters.
I know, I speak French.
Open the door.
Yeah.
Willkommen.
Bienvenue.
Welcome.
How do you do? I am Dr. Barry.
I am Nurse Sigrid Grabberhopper, his assistant.
Hi, I'm the patient.
Ta-da.
Why don't we get the pictures out of the way first? The world-famous miracle surgeon after yet another historic operation. Oh, don't mind him. He just dropped in for a shower.
Who is he? Oh, he's nobody.
I'm just a plumber. No pictures. I insist. No pictures. One more. How's this?
Oh. How far is this going to go?
I'm not sure.
I'm not either.
Donna, I know that it was difficult for you to do what I wanted, to send out this invitation.
I'm glad you understand that.
Well, I'm trying.
Is it that hard?
Let's just say that it's a beginning.
Michael, I want you to know the vow that I took when I said we would be honest, no more lies, ever, ever, ever.
We'll see.
I have a wonderful idea. I know that you're not hungry, but maybe you could come up to the house and have a drink and we could look at baby pictures of Marley. Okay?
I'd like that, yeah. But first, though, I have to make a phone call. I have to phone Singapore. I have to call before the market closes.
And then you'll come up later?
If you're sure you want me. Be there.
Let yourself in. See
you soon. Hi, Neal.
Hi. Look at the cat tractor.
We just went to see the worst movie, didn't we?
Yeah, I think it would have been better if they'd shown it backwards.
Yeah, he's a real movie buff, I guess.
No kidding.
Oh, you two, excuse me for just a second.
Yeah.
Hi.
Well, hello, Chris.
So, you're working here?
Yeah, I started today. May I take your order?
No. How is it?
Fabulous. Milkshake, apple pie, hamburger?
No, nothing for me, thanks.
Okay, I got it.
So, have you moved into that new apartment yet?
Yep.
It's by the shipyard, right?
Yeah, it's a walk-up.
You got a phone?
No, not yet. Why? Were you planning on calling me?
Come on, Nancy. We're still friends, aren't we?
What's the matter? Pam Bondi too intellectual for you? Hmm?
Nancy.
I'm sorry. Gee, I shouldn't have said that. Excuse me. I got a lot of things to do.
So, you're sweeping out your stables for the uncle? Mm-hmm. Must be kind of a letdown after being a super spy.
Yeah, well, things are a little tight financially. I'm thinking of branching out.
Oh, don't tell me.
Yeah. I mean, your last stable hand quit, and you need writing lessons.
You want me to put in a good word for you?
Yeah. I also want to know why you're going out with Chris Chapin.
He interests me.
Oh, come on. The only man who interests you is Jake McKinnon. Don't bother denying it.
Yeah, well, can a girl have a good time?
Yeah. But why do you have to hurt Nancy?
Nancy who?
You know, if I were up to something, I'd try the more roundabout method, too. But how does Chris and Nancy fit in to Jake?
You know, I think that you've been a spy too long, because you're seeing secret workings in something that's just an accidental meeting. Excuse me.
He'll talk to you later. Auf Wiedersehen.
Thanks for coming.
See ya.
I am not accustomed to having my orders disobeyed, Monsieur Winthrop.
And I am not accustomed to being ordered to stay away from the woman that I love.
There is a reason for these rules, you fool. She must concentrate.
Who are you calling a fool, you arrogant twit?
How dare you yell at him?
What do you think you are, jail keepers? This is America. We believe in freedom here. Patients have rights.
Yeah. My country.
I love this woman. You can't keep her locked up. What is this, a zoo, and she's an animal?
What's going on here?
She can't be kept away from her loved ones and her family. That is absolutely ridiculous.
I think the doctor would like to say something.
Merci, mademoiselle. Since you are all here, I would like to say a few words about my patient. She has made remarkable progress.
I'm okay.
It worked. She won't be paralyzed. Shh. Pardon.
She must continue with therapy every day and continue with exercise. But she can go home tomorrow.
Yeah! Hey, she's going home!
Oh, yeah!
Nice work.
So, how's Nancy?
Gee, that's a... good question. You want to eat?
Actually, no. I'm not feeling real well. I think I should go home and turn in early, but I had to talk to Nancy first. It's, some stuff about Marley.
Sure.
It's, about the wedding, you know, where she's getting her shoes dyed, stuff like that.
Yeah, sure.
Excuse me.
Uh-huh.
Hi, Nance.
May I help you?
I was just wondering if you knew what time the powerhouse gets packed.
I beg your pardon?
Well, I was wondering if Chris and I had time to grab a hamburger because I really hate crowds.
Why are you asking me this? Why don't you call them yourself?
Not that I think we'll be there that long at all. You know, I don't want to spend all of my energy on the dance floor, if you get my meaning.
No, why don't you spell it out for me?
Kind of like to save some energy for later.
You sure spread it around, don't you, Victoria?
Well, love the one you're with. Mm-hmm. That's my motto.
Because you lost Jake.
Yeah. Well, love the one you're with is still my motto. See you, Nancy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go.
What?
You haven't eaten anything.
I'm tired.
Okay. I'll see you around.
Okay.
What do you suppose she's up to?
Don't you think it's pretty obvious, Neal?
Yeah, with Vicky, you can't be too sure.
You brought it.
I told you I would.
Oh,
I'm almost scared to open it. Is it the right one?
Oh, yes. Oh, it's perfect. Beautiful.
Well, I thought it might kind of cheer you up.
Oh, you bet it will. Thank you.
You're welcome. Oh, Kathleen.
Oh. No, it's actually happening. Cass spoke to the priest and set the date and everything.
Really full steam ahead, huh?
Mrs. Cass, what?
You know, even Pops was starting to come around. Well, he was until he walked in here and he saw Cass standing there soaking wet. What happened?
Her condition is excellent.
Are you sure?
Elle est formidable. I expect wonderful progress.
And you gave her instructions?
Above all, she must not overdo. Nothing to re-injure the damaged area. Only rest and supervised exercise.
I'll see to it. She'll be fine.
Please, gentlemen, this is a very critical time for Kathleen. If she puts any strain on her back, any sudden movement, she could be paralyzed again.
I understand.
I'll understand.
We understand.
Good. I leave her in your hands. And I will catch the Concorde back to Paris. My wife wants to see me.
Listen, I'm sorry about what I said to you before. I want to thank you for everything.
Yeah, we appreciate everything you've done.
Very nice meeting you, Monsieur McKinnon. And you, Monsieur Winthrop.
Au voyage.
Au revoir.
Au revoir.
We did it, Vince!
Kathleen and the doctor helped a little.
Yeah, but she's gonna make it. She's gonna be okay, huh?
Winthrop!
What?
Do me a favor.
What?
Go dry up.
don't want to drink. We both know what we want.
Mustn't keep Michael waiting.
It can't be all that bad.
Marley, you try putting in 8 hours on your feet all day and then tell me how bad it can't be.
Look, once you get used to all of this, you're gonna find out that you really like it here.
Marley, you wanted to work here. I was forced into it.
No, Maisie and Clarice are just terrific. Besides, it's gonna feel good earning your own money.
Yeah. Hey, how was Chicago?
Oh, you have to come see all the things I got. Come by tomorrow?
All right.
How's your new apartment?
Awful.
You all right? Is something bothering you?
Your sister was in here earlier.
Vicky?
Yeah. She was with Chris.
Sorry.
It's really no problem. How's Jake?
I went by to see him this afternoon.
Guess he must have missed you a lot, huh?
Yeah, I missed him, too.
Listen, Marley, have you had a chance to really talk about what went on in the mine?
Yes. Yeah, we've talked about it a lot.
But even about...
Yes, him and Victoria.
Mm-hmm. And are you sure that not...
Nothing happened. Jake said nothing happened, and I believe him.
Don't mind me. It's just Victoria, you know? And I don't know, I'm pretty suspicious by nature.
But they loved each other. But that was a long time ago.
I'm sorry. Listen, I shouldn't have even said anything. Please, forget about it.
I know people must wonder.
No, not me. I really like Jake. Oh, boy. Another customer back on the feet.
See ya. Tomorrow.
Okay.
Who are you? And what do you think you're doing?
Absolutely nothing to worry about. I'm, Michael Garrison. Marley and Victoria's father.
You want to run that by me again?
I'll see you tomorrow, bright and early.
I'm actually going home?
Yeah, it's over. And you're going to be okay.
You heard Dr. Barry out.
Thanks for the ring.
You're welcome.
Goodbye, Mr. Winthrop.
I'm leaving, mein Commandant. I'm leaving. I love you.
I love you, too. The doctor said Miss McKinnon must rest. And no sudden movements.
Okay. I'll see you.
Mr.
Winthrop? Yes.
Mr. Winthrop?
Coming, Miss Grabberhopper, coming. Love your ring.
Thank you.
is brought to you by Prel Shampoo and Prel Conditioner, the unbeatable bodybuilding system for hair. Prel Fullness, Prel Body, Prel Nice. Join us each weekday for the continuing story of Another World.